This is the Yubikey 5, and the makers of this little device say it can help to protect you and drastically reduce the chances that the bad guys will get into your stuff. In fact, when used with an application called a password manager, it says it can reduce the number of passwords you need to remember, and in some cases, eliminate the need for a password altogether. Can it really do all that? Let's find out. Hi, I'm Orman Beckles, aka the High Tech Nomad, and in this video, we're going to look at the brand new Yubikey 5, and I'll show you how to use it and a password manager as a foundation for a simple to use, but highly effective way to keep hackers out of your stuff. Now, I looked at all of the videos that are up on YouTube regarding the YubiKey. Some of them are as short as 13 seconds long. That's not enough time to show you how to use it. On the other hand, the time it takes to show you is probably about an hour, and quite frankly, most of you will not sit still for an hour video. So I'm going to have to break this into parts. This is part one, and I will publish the other parts as quickly as possible. To show me that this is the kind of information that you want, please hit the like button, please hit the subscribe button, and please leave comments below letting me know that this is the type of video that you want to see regarding complicated subjects like this. YubiKey has been around since 2007. However, you may have only heard about them because recently Google published an article saying how they distributed the keys to its 85,000 employees and made it mandatory that they use them. And since then, it has reported zero successful hacking attempts. So Google was actually so impressed that they now make their own security key called Titan. But in my opinion, Yubico is still the best. Now, you should have two keys because once we start locking things down, much like your house or car keys, if we lose the keys, we're going to lock ourselves out. Now, I don't want that to frighten you, unless, of course, you're a person that loses all of your car keys on a regular basis. In which case, I would suggest that you get three keys and put one in a safe or give it to a friend that's less accident prone. This keychain one, which also has NFC, is the one that we're going to carry with us and use with our phone and use when we're out and about. These nano versions are small and are meant to be left in the computer for extended periods of time. As you can see, they have very low profiles and won't get in the way. So we're going to start simple and work our way up. So let's go ahead and log into a Gmail account that I've set up just for this example. So here we are, it is YubiKey video. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on that. And then I'm gonna put in the password, which in this case is password. And I'm telling you that because we're going to show that even if people know what the password is, we're still gonna be able to keep them from getting our stuff. So you can see the password is password, PA $$. We try to be tricky here, WORD. So if we did nothing else and we wrote this down on a piece of paper next to our computer and somebody got that, they could go home and they could log in. All right. So we're going to go into our Google account and we're going to go into sign into Google. And what a lot of places try to get you to use is something called two-step authentication or multi-step authentication. Basically, they're going to ask you to do two things when you log in. Now, the problem is that you don't even want to do one thing to log in. But it's safer if you, you know, it would be nice if we didn't have to put locks on the door, but we do. So it's better, the more locks we have, the better. But we want to make it nice and easy. So of course, they talk here about turning on your two-step authentication and all of the good stuff that comes with doing that. So we'll go ahead and go to the next one. We've now turned on two-step authentication. We have to log in again. So we'll log in again, $$WORD. And let's go ahead and click next. Now it says, should we set up your phone for your two-step authentication? Let's go ahead and set that up. Now, you're gonna have to do this to turn on two-step authentication, but this is not a good idea. And while you might think, hey, that's pretty cool, It'll send a text message to me. I have my phone. I'm fairly secure. Everything's fine and dandy. That's not really the case. This is better than nothing. This is better than having just the bad password. All right, so I got my code, as you can see down here in the bottom of my screen. Now, you might be wondering how I got this code that was sent to my phone on the screen. That's covered in another video called Join, which is a nice little software that you can use so that you can see your text messages on your computer screen. So check that out if you're interested in seeing that. But the important part here is we've now turned on two-step authentication. Now that we've turned on two-step verifications, we have a bunch of different choices. The first choice we want to look at is backup codes. These are 10 single-use codes that will allow you to get into your account should anything else happen. So for example, if you lose your phone or we lose our security key, I strongly suggest that you make use of this feature. To use it, you're going to click on Show Codes. It will show you these codes, and then you can go ahead and download or print them. And obviously you don't want to download and print them and leave them on your desk. You literally want to put these like in a safe somewhere, knowing that you can still get in with one of these codes should there be a problem. Now, for those of you who are hurrying to scurry down to look at my codes now, you can change new codes by doing this. Once you do that, the codes that were previously on the screen will not work for this account. So obviously when I'm through with this video, I'll hit it again and again and again. So that's the first thing we want to take a look at. The next thing we want to take a look at is using the Google prompt, which is sort of nice. And that's specific to Google. And what that will do is when you try to log in, it will use one of the Google apps on your phone that you're already using to say, is it okay if you can get in? And that's fairly decent. That will allow you to get in. And that is fairly secure. The next one is Google Authenticator. And this is not too bad either. This generates what we call a one-time password or a timed one-time password. And what happens is it will show a series, usually six numbers, that change every 30 seconds. And those are very, very difficult, if not impossible, to replicate. So again, using Google Authenticator is fairly decent. Now, the problem with that in most cases is people do not want to pick up their phone, look at the six numbers, and then put the six numbers in. Or perhaps they don't have their phone. So that brings us to the last one. And the last one is the one that we want to talk about. This is using a security key. So how do we add a YubiKey to our account? Well, that's actually fairly easy. All we do is add security key. It will show us the key. It says put it in. It says okay. If you've got it in now, it's going to glow green for a second. I touch it. And that's it. See, it says it's about to do our security. And it says, what key is it? This one happens to be the USB-C key that I have. We're okay if we lose one because we still have our backup codes. But for the sake of this discussion, I will add a second key. So I have the other key from around my neck. I've now added my second key, and this is the key that I actually wear around my neck with my dog tags. So I now have two keys, and I may even add a third or fourth key, add my wife's key, and then I also have a master key that I keep down in the safe. The problem here is this phone number. We already said that this is the weak link, so I'm gonna actually go in and click on remove phone. I do not want them to be able to send a text message. And there you go, Bob's your uncle. We have an account that is pretty well protected. The only way you're going to get in is to have my password and either one of these two keys. If you do not have either one of these two keys or this backup code that I'm going to keep in the safe, you're not getting into this account. So using this method, we have a very, very secure account. So much so that I'm not changing my password. Please feel free to try and go and get into this account. Again, the email address is shown on the screen. Go ahead, have at it. You're not going to get in. Now, unfortunately, not every site is currently making use of the security keys, but a lot of them are. For example, let me go ahead and log into Facebook. As you can see, you cannot log into my Facebook account unless you have one of these keys. So for example, on Twitter, it's asking me again to log in with my security key. Now, unfortunately, not all the websites currently make use of these security keys. And until they do, we're going to have to find another way of making sure that we have a different password for each website without having to keep all of those passwords in our heads. Luckily, we have LastPass. LastPass is a password manager. It's going to allow us to create complicated passwords and have them associated to the websites that we use. Now, you won't have to type in this password that often, but it is suggested that you make this an extremely strong password. As I said before, it's best to use a phrase, something that you can put in that's easy for you to remember, but is very, very long. In my case, I'll say, in olden days, a glimpse of stocking. And those are the first words of the Cole Porter song, Anything Goes. Again, this is just a demo. I'm trying to show you that by using a phrase, we can have a very long, complex password. And here we are at the LastPass dashboard. Now, luckily for us, LastPass works with YubiKey. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to tighten our security by locking down our LastPass account with our YubiKey. And we do that by going to Account Settings, clicking on Multi-Factor Authentication Options. And as you can see, we can use the Google Authenticator and a couple of other different ones, but the one that we want to do is the YubiKey. So we're going to go ahead and click on Enable, to which it's now asking us for our two keys. So we're going to, at least two keys, as you can see, I can have up to five keys. Because again, this is a family account, so more than one family member might be using it. So we're going to go ahead and... So let's go ahead and log back in. We'll put in our password. In olden days, a glimpse of stocking. We can't get in. I don't mind if you have this password, because you ain't getting in unless you have one of my security keys. And in this case, I only have one. I should at least register two. Now we have a secure LastPass. We now have a secure password manager. Now let's see how we use LastPass with other websites. All right, so the next part of this is that we need to load the LastPass extension. So we're going to go in and we're going to say LastPass extension. As you can see, it's a free extension available in the Google Chrome Play Store. All we do is click on that and then click on Add to Chrome. It says, can I add the extension? We say yes. And we'll end up with a little icon here on the end that says LastPass. Here we're going to go ahead and put in our account information. And as you can see, I can't even install this extension without my security key. So I'll go ahead and activate my security key. And we're all set. Now let's go and sign up for a service and see how we're going to use LastPass. So now let's go ahead and see how we use LastPass. There's something very curious here that I want to point out to you, and it speaks to security and how your information is constantly being scanned, reviews, and in some cases used against you. So I've come to the Yahoo site and I've come to use this as an example to show you how to use LastPass, and we're going to click on that in a minute. But I want you to notice what's happening here. The two ads that I'm getting sent, the one up there a minute ago was for a YubiKey, And the one over here is for LastPass. So that means they've been monitoring what words we're using and where we're going, and then they're feeding us ads based upon that. Now, in this case, these are two ads that don't make any difference because we already have LastPass and we're talking about the YubiKey. But I want you to see just how your data is constantly under attack, and that's why we have to take these steps. So we're going to go ahead and click on sign in, and we're going to go to sign up, to which it asks what is our first name, our last name, our password, a phone number, a date of birth, and gender. Now what I want you to see here is that under password we now have an extra little icon, and this is being generated by LastPass. And what we do is we click on that, and it's going to show us this LastPass generator. This is going to help us generate really strong passwords specific for each site. And we have a bunch of different options. At the very least, we can change the number of characters. I usually try to go for the maximum amount of characters just because I don't have to remember it anyways, and it looks kind of cool. So we're going to say 20 characters. I can actually come down here to options, and I can do things like make sure it adds in dollar signs or things of that nature. Now this is good because some websites will require that you do use a special character, and some websites will say you can't use it if it's a special character. They also have this little pronounceable, which I don't know if you can call that pronounceable, but apparently it says that that word is a pronounceable word. We're just going to go back to all characters. I usually, just for the heck of it, click on copy password. That will put it into the buffer, into the copy paste, and then I can just say paste. Now, I've gone through all of those steps, and again, I had to put in a phone number. Wasn't really happy with that because, again, this just, it helps to link things. So if they steal all the information from here and all the information from there, they now have some way of correlating the two accounts. You'll also see again now that we have an advertisement for LastPass down here in the corner. So we're logged in. Now, how does LastPass help us to log in the next time? To do that, let's go ahead and log out. Let's go ahead and log back in. As you can see, it's prompting me to enter my information. And normally I would type it in. But now, since we're using LastPass, we have this little box off to the side. This little box off to the side is important because it's telling us that LastPass recognizes this website and has at least one login for this website. If I click on that box, it will show me the logins that are available. Now you may have websites with multiple logins. For example, maybe you and your partner have a Yahoo account. In my case, we only have one, so I'm going to go down and I'm going to click on it. It's now entered my username. I'm going to go ahead and click next. It's now asking me for my password. Don't worry, I don't have to type in that long 20 character password. All I have to do is come over to LastPass and again, select the correct entry. I then click sign in, and Bob's your uncle. We are logged in. So I'm going to stop here for part one. I'm already editing part two, and it will be put up shortly. Please hit the like button. Please hit the subscribe button so that I know that you guys like videos like this that are in detail. We're breaking a lot of, from what I saw, you guys really like these kinds of videos. So just let me know. Put a message in the comment. Tell me it was too long. Tell me it was too short. Hey, give me some direction. This is how we learn. We're going to be working together. So until the next time, this is the High Tech Nomad signing out.